punished. Bring more deaths. I shall grant thee eye and claw. Feed me more.
Thank you. You appear to be doing well. Very good. Well then, would you like to learn an incantation? May the Golden Order shine through you.
You've met Gurranq, I take it. Then owing to our duties shared, we are now comrades in arms. I think you've earned this. The power of the Golden Order to aid the hunt of those who live in death. With a man named Roger, you know, the piteous fellow hiding away on the balcony. He was a formidable spellblade in times past. Don't let his easy air deceive you. He was wise beyond his years, stout of heart and clear of mind. No more, though. You see him now, ravaged by thorns, muttering and rambling. Like he's half dead already. I can't stomach to watch. Take well the lesson, friend. That's how you end up when seduced by those who live in death. When grace is sullied, it rots people from the inside. Breaks them. I serve the Golden Order, that I might put this crooked land to rights. Following only the guidance of the Great Elden Ring. Those who live in death fall outside the principles of the Golden Order. Their mere existence sullies the guidance of gold, tainting its truth. And so it is, the vermin must be exterminated, down to the very last.
Divinity, have mercy and grant me forgiveness. The road is yet long. A god is not easily felled. But one day without fail, you will have your wish. So please grant me forgiveness, Queen Marika. You, is it? I didn't notice you there. I'll be doing my job, same as ever. Just lay out your arms. Those words were not meant for you. I may be prisoner to you, tarnished lot, but my prayers are mine, and mine alone. Well, I've had my say. I'll be more careful too.
Once more, the blessing is still aflame in your breast, dear. Would you like to be held? Regardless? Now, come closer. You are so very warm. My dear, have you ever heard of black knife prints? Dear Roger likes to talk of them when abed, and the ancient plot in which the first of the demigods was slain. The black knives wielded by the assassins who committed the act, along with the impressions they made, somehow hide the truth of the conspiracy. These grand affairs are hardly my forte, but dear Roger began to weep as he spoke. In truth, I've heard tell from someone else about the black knife prints that fascinate dear Roger so. But it wouldn't be right to give this to him, stuck as he is in the round table hold. Perhaps you could make use of it?
Hey!